Now you know how to ask students a single question or how to give them long form assignments using Google Classroom. It's also easy to create quiz assignments which have many questions in them. And the best part is that you don't have to grade them. Google Classroom does it for you. Pick the class in which you want to add the quiz assignment. Go to Classwork, click on Create, and then select Quiz Assignment. Did you notice something? Google Classroom automatically created a Google Form for you. Wait, what's that? Google Forms is a tool that helps you measure student progress, administer tests, and much more. You will see how easy this tool is for creating quizzes. Okay, back to our original screen. Give your assignment a title and an appropriate description. If it's a graded quiz, it'll be a good idea to keep the grade importing option on. Here, the word grade means the test scores of your students. And then you can open the Google form by clicking here. This is the screen you will see now. You can name your quiz by editing this section. You can then tell your students what this quiz is all about using the description box here. To make it a little more lively, you can click here and add a theme or an image to your quiz. The first question box is generated by Google Forms by default. To add your second question, you simply have to click on the plus icon you see here. Now you're ready to post your first question of this quiz. The beauty about Google Forms is that it gives you a choice to ask many different types of questions. It could be a short answer question or a long answer question or even a multiple choice question maybe. Let's pick multiple choice for now. Let me add a sample question with 4 answer choices here. Once you have entered your question, you should also add an answer key. You should mention the correct answer here and assign points to this question. So if the student answers this correctly, she will get 2 points. The answer feedback button is important as well. Clicking on it allows you to enter the feedback required for students depending on their answer. If they answer incorrectly, we could write something like this and give a video link for reference. And for correct answers, we could give feedback like this. And then we click on save. If you want to make it mandatory for the student to attempt a question, change this to required. This will not allow the student to go ahead and submit the quiz unless she has answered this question. You could also add images to your question or answer options by clicking here. Now let me add another question here by clicking on the plus icon. Well, what if you want to see the handwritten, detailed answers that your students have written? Here's the question. In that case, we can select the file upload option here and click on continue. These are the different file types your students can upload. So your students can write detailed answers maybe in their notebook and click pictures and upload images. Or if the answer runs into pages, they can also upload a PDF file. If some student is finding it difficult to write because of an injury, she can also upload an audio file by narrating the answer. As you can see, there are plenty of options here. Interesting, isn't it? You could add as many questions as you like and your quiz will keep getting auto-saved. If you wish to see how students are going to see your quiz, you can use the preview option right here. What if you want your students to attempt your quiz a maximum of just one time? Well, you have that option too. You just need to go to the settings section and click on limit to one response. In the middle, we see the presentation section here. You can also choose to show your students a progress bar, which tells them how many questions they have answered and how many are left. Your quiz is now ready. You may close this tab and come back to this page. You could also refresh the page once for your changes to take effect. You will see your quiz assignment here on your dashboard now. Clicking on Edit will open the quiz assignment again. Here you can make it a part of a topic. And then you can assign or schedule for a later date. Your students now will be able to see your quiz in that particular topic of your class. And once your students have attempted the quiz, you will see all the responses in the grade section here. Let's click on the quiz assignment here. we can see that all 9 students of your class have turned the assignment in, which means they have submitted it. To get these scores, we just have to click on Import Grades here. And then we can see the scores of the students on the left. Clearly, Google Classroom did the job of automatically grading them. It does save you a lot of time as no manual checks are required. You would have to manually check only the detailed or subjective answers written by your students. Google Forms is one of the easiest tools to use for quizzes and assignments. And believe me here, if you spend just 2 focused hours on it, you'll understand almost 80% of it. So don't let anything hold you back. Happy teaching!